full tomorrow. There's no question about that. You know, it's always tough to play on the road. This is obviously a very good test for a road opener. There's no question about that. You know, you look at Purdue's stats in their lineup, you know, all upperclassmen, all experienced guys for the most part, and, you know, their starting five is averaging double-figure scoring. So, you know, it's going to be a very tough test, and I've never actually been there for a game. I've been there. I haven't been there for a game, but, you know, from what Greg says, he's obviously very familiar with them and other people. It's a very, very difficult place to play. Just from a – fans are very enthusiastic, and it's very loud. So, you know, it's going to be a very tough test. We know that, but I know our guys are excited for it. They're up for the challenge, and it'll be good to get a road game under our belt. So, you know, hopefully we're ready to go. And like I said, it's going to be tough, but we're excited for it.
Well, this, you look at this day, we kind of maybe show you where you guys are at, your first.
No question. Yeah, it's going to be a very good barometer for where we are as a team right now. You know, it's playing on the road is never easy. This is about as tough as it gets. And I know they'll be ready to go. Purdue, I mean, for a lot of reasons. You know, obviously, they probably hoped they were going to do a little bit better last week in the Bahamas. I know they had a very good win against Arizona, and they played really, really well. So they're going to be ready to go. You know, obviously, we played them last year, so we have a little bit of familiarity with each other. But yeah, it's going to be a good gauge for where we are. You know, we're excited about it. You know, playing on the road is fun. It's obviously a lot more fun if you're able to get out of there with a road win. But you know, it's kind of what makes college basketball and college sports exciting, is playing on, in those kind of atmospheres. So I'm curious to see how our guys respond and see where we are.
Do you think you're ready?
I think we are. You know, the good news is, you know, knock on wood, that's good news, is we have two seniors, two juniors, and a sophomore who've all played significant minutes on the road in the ACC. So, you know, now I know Purdue obviously is one of the toughest home court advantages in the country, but we have guys who've been on the road. You know, I'm curious to see how our freshmen respond to it for the first time. It'll be a good test for them. But with that being said, it's a team effort. You know, it's not about two or three guys here, two or three guys there. It's about our whole team, so everybody's going to be ready to go.
Are you worried about the freshmen?
No, I'm not. I mean, look, there's no way to get experience on the road except to go on the road and play. So there's nothing we can do to, you know, simulate it or do anything like that. So they got to stick to our game plan and do what we need to do, and you know, hopefully it'll be successful.
What about you? Your first road game, how are you thinking about?
You know, I actually get more nervous. Believe it or not, I get more nervous for, even as an assistant, I was this way. I got more nervous for home games than I did road games. And I don't know why. Maybe it's because, maybe sometimes when you're at home, you just have somewhat of a relaxed feeling because you're playing in front of your own fans. Where on the road, you know that your back's up against the wall from the time you get off the bus. And so you know you're going to be ready. You know, and I was even like that as a player a little bit too. But look, at the end of the day, I'm just going to be on the sidelines. I can't set foot on the court. I just have to trust that our guys are ready, that we've given them a good game plan, and they're going to go out and execute it. Because at the end of the day, it's going to be up to the five guys that are on the floor.
Do you remember anything about your first road game?
I don't even remember what my first road game was. At Kansas. I can't even be able to go back and look. I really would have to think about that. You know, I know, remember we played Stanford in a neutral site. That wasn't a road game. But, you know, we were able, when I was playing here, we had a lot of success on the road, especially our last 2 years in the Big East. I think we were best in the Big East, I think. And you really don't remember the ones where you do well. You remember the ones where you don't do well. You know, I will never forget, as long as I live, our last regular season game my senior year at Georgetown with the conference championship on the line, and we lost, I think, by two or three or whatever it was. And, you know, those are the ones you remember, unfortunately. But, you know, it's tough, there's no question, but it's what makes being a student athlete in college fun. You know, whether it's football, basketball, you know, volleyball, baseball, soccer, doesn't matter what it is. Playing on the road is fun, you know, and it's a tough challenge, but it's something you look forward to.
David, you guys did such a good job against Haas last year, and obviously they're a different team. But what are kind of the challenges he's possessed, being 60, 70 pounds heavier than your guys in the middle?
Yeah, you know, it's almost like, where do you start when you talk about what challenges do they possess? You know, you got, like I said, you got five guys averaging double figures. You got two guys shooting over 50% from three, and then one shooting 43 and one shooting 38. So, you know, they obviously have a big time low post player in Haas in the middle, but they also have four guys around the perimeter that can shoot the daylights out of the ball. So, you know, you got to figure out, something's going to have to try to give somewhere. So you got to figure out what that is. But, you know, they're a very, very, very good offensive team. I mean, there's no question about it. When they get hot and they make shots, you know, they're really, really tough to defend. I know, I think one game earlier this year at home, they made 17 threes. So, you know, if you look at their home scores, they've scored over 100 every single time. So, you know, they can score the ball. There's no question. So we're gonna have to be at our A plus effort defensively if we want to try to get out of there with a win.
What's the difference in you know, they bring Hollins off the bench and he plays quite a bit, 7'3", I think. Difference in the way he plays and Haas plays? Or?
You know, obviously they're both huge, but Harms is, he's a little bit more skilled away from the basket, I guess. You know, Caleb Swanigan last year obviously was an All-American, so he was able to step out and shoot threes, and they played together once in a while. But when Harms comes in the game, you know, he can step out 17 feet, shoot it. You know, they're a little bit different, but at the same time, you know, no matter which guy's in the game, they're a very potent offensive team. So, you know, you got to try to do certain things and maybe contain certain things, but it's a challenge because when you have five guys that can score the ball, and, you know, it's, you can't really say, okay, well, we're just going to lock it on one because you got four others that can beat you. So,
watching, I'm assuming you watched a little bit of the tape from last year's game between the two. Mm-hmm. The four big guys that you guys rotated in all had really good games last year. What were they doing then, and I guess how can you hope that Ray Harris tap into that again this time?
Well, I mean, you know, Jalen and Mango, especially Mango, played very well in that game last year. You know, Mango, from a defensive standpoint, really battled the whole night. You know, Jalen did too. Ray obviously played well. Giannis played fairly well until he got, you know, hit in the head accidentally there in the second half. But, you know, it's having Mango and Jalen, those guys last year, obviously, they, from an experience standpoint, they helped. Not that Ray and Giannis aren't experienced. Of course they are. But, you know, it's a little bit different. When last year you've got two juniors, a senior, and then Ray was a sophomore. Well, now obviously you've got Ray and Giannis, but, you know, Malik's a freshman, Lance is a freshman, so they're just a little bit younger. But, you know, it's, we just got to try to look. They're tough to guard inside because, you know, Haas and Harms are huge, they're massive, and they're very skilled. You know, you can't take away from their skill level. But, you know, at the same time, you know, our front court guys are experienced, so it'll be a good test both ways. But again, I think it comes down more to anything just team versus team, not so much individual matchup versus individual matchup.
Did you watch all three of their games in the Bahamas? Or?
I did, yeah. I actually, the first one, the Tennessee game, was on during the day here in between our individuals and practice, so I just watched it on TV. It was a great game. And, you know, Tennessee, you know, I was impressed with how hard they played. And you know, watching Purdue against Arizona on Friday was impressive. You know, very, very impressive. Because Arizona, from a talent standpoint, is about as good as it gets. You know, and obviously, I think Coach Painter would agree. At the beginning of the week, heading into it, I'm sure if they would have said Purdue and Arizona are going to play each other, everybody would have thought about a championship game, you know. But it was impressive to watch Purdue against Arizona. I mean, the way they shot the ball and to score, you know, 89 points against a town like that's very impressive.
How do you explain, how do you explain the way they played the first two games and then to beat Arizona by 25 points?
Maybe. You know, they shot the ball well against Arizona. You know, it helps when you make shots to start the game. But, you know, they have so many guys that can make shots. You know, if you stop or contain one or two, well, then there's one or two or three more that can shoot the ball just as well. You know, it's like a guy like Ryan Klein, for example, who I watched when he was in high school because I was up at IUPUI. You know, percentage-wise, he's not shooting the ball well, but he's probably one of the better shooters on the team. You know, they really have done a good job recruiting the last couple of years to where now they have guys who can really shoot the ball, and it's made them very tough to go against because of the way they score.
Are you haven't used it a ton, but the last two games with the zone, are you kind of pleased with it? Is it further along than maybe you thought with all the new guys?
You know, the reason it was successful against Southern Illinois, I think, was because, you know, obviously our starters that game were more familiar with it. You know, the younger guys are learning it a little bit. It just takes a while. You know, when Honest and Q and Ray and Dang and BJ and all those guys were freshmen, they didn't know it either at this point in the year. You know, it just takes a while. But, you know, we're going to have to use it here and there against certain teams not. It's just going to be a matchup thing. You know, the other night, obviously, we got against St. Francis. They did a good job of exposing us off the dribble. You know, maybe I should have gone back zone a little bit sooner, maybe not. It's just hard to say. But, you know, it's something we're going to continue to use here and there. But, again, it's just a game-by-game matchup.
What's Purdue doing defensively?
You know, they're predominantly man. You know, they can do a wide variety of things. You know, Matt's always been a very, very good defensive coach. I remember even, you know, the 1 year we played when I was a senior, I didn't play, but playing against them, I remember how tough they were defensively. You know, just hard-nosed man-to-man. Obviously, their size and their strength and their physicality makes them tough as well, and, you know, even more so on their home court. So, you know, they're going to be a physical team. We just got to, you know, we got to come ready to play. We got to try to match their physicality and, you know, see where it goes.